Everyone join.
I'm sorry, my voice isn't really here. I'm going to try to do the best I can to speak. I am in an AP class right now, AP Bio, and I've been recommended for 3 AP classes next year, AP Stats, AP US, and AP Chemistry. I am aspiring to be an ophthalmologist, person basically that works with eyes. See, if you guys with glasses, maybe I can help you out in the near future. Won't really be possible if you take away the AP classes and the extracurriculars. Where to begin? I'm marching band, arista, jazz band, like all these extracurriculars, like they really mean something to us. They propel us to go forward. They make us want to wake up every morning and go to school just to get there. Go through all our AP classes, do all of our homework, staying up till like 12, 1 o'clock in the morning. You know why? Because we actually care. We really care. Like, cutting these things, it's just like, what are we supposed to do with ourselves? Like Kiana said, a lot of us, we're just going to be like, what are we supposed to do with ourselves? I can almost guarantee that a whole bunch of these people in these clubs, nothing to do, they're going to go out and do whatever the heck they want. They really will. They start doing drugs, they start being bad, doing this, doing that, and then all they have to say is, huh, well, when I was younger, I used to be this, until, you know, the board cut all of our electives and all of our APs, so I turned out like this. It's like, when I heard, like, the APs and everything were getting cut, I mean, last year, it's always been threatened, but this is the worst I've ever seen it. I was outraged. You'd see me walking through the hallways mad because my AP classes and my extracurriculars could get cut. I know what colleges I want to get into. I'm only in 10th grade. I know exactly what I want to do. I picked out my path. And you guys cutting this is going to throw everything off. And not only me, but everybody else. There are people that have been aspiring to be things since what? Since they're 5 years old, since they're in 7th grade. And just going to throw their path, like, just going to throw it off. So, I mean, yes, I understand you have to make cuts. I get that. You don't have, there's not enough money to, like, satisfy everybody in the whole entire world. I know. Times are tough, but you gotta prioritize. I mean, I know what I want. They know what they want. And you guys say, yeah, we hear you, we're here for you. But honestly, I don't think, like, you're fighting hard enough. You should be doing everything in your willpower to keep us, like, having our education. Like, our education's being cut. A shorter day, like, no extracurricular activities, no APs, no honors. What am I supposed to do? What are they supposed to do? What are we supposed to do as a community? Just, like, thank you so much. We want to get somewhere, and we know you want to get somewhere. You guys got to meet us halfway. That's all I got to say.
Hello, members of the board. My name is Matthew Roberts. I'm a senior at Ramapo High School and president of the East Ramapo Marching Band. And honestly, I don't like coming to these things. I could easily stay home. I don't have any little brothers or sisters coming into this district next year, but I could honestly just stay home and not care, but I'm here, nevertheless. One thing I just want to say, when I was going to come to this meeting today, a thought popped into my mind and I remembered something. I had a job interview a couple months ago, and they asked me something about diversity. What does diversity mean to you? All the other people answered something about racial diversity, cultural. But I answered differently. I said, diversity isn't what color of skin is and or what they believe in. Diversity is what a person knows, what's in here and what's in here. Sports and clubs diversify a person and make them well-rounded. Well-rounded people are successful. That's all I want to say.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Olivier Midi. I'm a junior at Ramapo High School, and I'm treasurer of the school student activity council. As of late, residents of this school district have heard time and time again of various discussions over the significance of the annual budget, the changes it will bring, and the impact it will ultimately have on those working in and attending district schools. Year after year, on either side of the aisle, reasons have been given so as to explain why past budgets were passed as they were, and yet, year after year, additional cuts to public school programs have been made. And while it may be true that the very word budget invokes a financial meaning, this year's budget goes well beyond the realm of economics. Tax hikes are not at stake. Financial savings are not at stake. Money is not at stake. What are at stake are the very characteristics that makes East Ramapo the district that it is. The district budget proposal currently being prepared aims to eliminate a number of public school activities and programs not deemed mandated by New York State. However, such mandates are minimum requirements, and the word minimum is used for a reason. No school, let alone an entire district, can be expected to proudly and successfully stand out without any advantage to set it apart. From the kindergarteners of Margetts and Summit Park to the upperclassmen of Spring Valley and Ramapo, our source of pride is found in our dedication to excellence, artistically, athletically, and without a doubt, academically. It is in these programs we find our drive, our talents, and our potential. In these programs we find our identity. To restrict us to only exploring mandated education ultimately hinders the very purpose of school, discovering that which you hope to pursue for the rest of your life. I am more than a name on a sheet of paper followed by numerical grades. I am a musician, I am an athlete, and I am an active member of my student body, in addition to being a scholar. For me and my fellow students, to be deprived of the very foundation of our present success would be nothing short of an insult, a discredit to all that we have worked so hard to attain. In my 3 short years as a member of the Ramapo community, I have seen every face of student life the school has had to offer. I'm a varsity member of the East Ramapo Wrestling Team, which was acknowledged on the county level for our sportsmanlike character with the Jerry Maguire Memorial Award. As a saxophonist, I've partaken in or performed with nearly every primary and secondary musical group that our district has to offer, the Old County and Old District Concert and Jazz Bands, the Rockland Community College Jazz Ensemble, the musical production of Greece at Ramapo High School, and of course, the world-famous East Ramapo High School Marching Band. I'm an active member of multiple clubs, including Ramapo Basic and Model United Nations. And within the coming weeks, I will be inducted into the National Honor Society and others like it. Moreover, my life as a student is not a unique occurrence. For the majority of our students, many of whom join me here tonight, our lives revolve around such an active nature. We contribute to our school community and are more than grateful for all that it offers us. And even if one would like to insinuate that our students simply don't care, the prevailing evidence demonstrates the contrary. As I said before, this budget deals with more than financial matters. The contents of this budget will make or break the very fabric of who we are as a district. The East Ramapo Central School District is defined by more than numbers and bills. It is founded on the students whom it serves and those who support us. We value our schools, we care about our schools, and we will make every necessary effort to prove it. Thank you.
Everybody up here to tomorrow night, the Asian Culture Enlightenment, the club is holding a fundraiser at the Crown Plaza, and it's for Doctors Without Borders. So I'm inviting everybody to go out. It starts at 6:30. It's $30, but all the money's going to Doctors Without Borders. So hopefully everybody can come and show some support. As I said before, my name is Ms. Nicole Canada, and I would first like to start by thanking the board and every person in this room for giving me the chance to speak before you tonight. I stand here before you, a proud product of the East Ramapo School District, one of many, and due to the work and effort put in by these teachers, I can say that I am graduating high school this June with my fellow classmates. But tonight, I would like to share a couple things that I gained for being in this school district. Specifically, Mr. Lieberman's U.S. history class. The president's cabinet, political parties, congressional committees, and judicial review. I'm sure everyone has heard of these four systems one way or another. They are a part of the unwritten constitution. And for those of you who don't know what the unwritten constitution is, it refers to the ideas and processes that are accepted as a needed part of American government, regardless of the fact that they are not actually in the Constitution. These ideas and processes came about through custom and precedent. Many aspects of the unwritten Constitution are so ingrained into our system that many do not even realize that they are not laws or provisions of the Constitution. And so, many of you are wondering why I'm telling you all of these fun facts. It's because even though those four systems are not physically in the Constitution, they are in place because they keep people in order and enable people to obtain jobs in a jobless economy. Even with these tough economic times that we are having, I have yet to hear Congress say that they are cutting the cabinet because it costs too much money. The job of the cabinet is like sports, APs, kindergarten, marching band, nurses, librarians, chair people, security, deans, and assistant principals in our district. Without them, our district, our community won't run smoothly, and the money problems we have to solve now will have even worse effects later. Kids will be on the street, causing trouble, being derelicts, as my teachers would put it as. It's not good. So we need to stop thinking at the margin and think about the long-term effects. But after hearing what you guys proposed tonight, it seems as if you have already made decisions that have affected the lives of thousands without really discussing them with the people that are being affected. All I hear are cuts from the public sector. Why don't I hear cuts about administration or even cuts from the private sector? I can't really comprehend that, and I'm a pretty smart kid. In conclusion, I just would like to say that even though you guys made decisions already, just to think about it, really think, and just imagine what the world would be like if every kid went home after school and just got into trouble. Thank you for your time.
Hello, I'm not going to yell, so I'm going to give a mic. My name is Sarai Rivera. I am a senior at Ramapo Senior High School. And I just want to give you guys a tiny bit, it's not too long, a little bit of my history. I started out high school in New York City Catholic School. In a New York City Catholic school, and I hated it there. It was dreadful. And when I moved up here, I started going to Ramapo Senior High School, and it was like heaven to me. I'd never been in a public school, and it was just amazing. So many opportunities, so many doors were open, and honestly, because of that, I'm actually a better person for it, because of these opportunities that I've been given. I'm part of drama club, and I'm actually part of a few other things, but I'm just a little bit nervous right now, so I can't remember. So what I basically wrote a little while ago was this. From what I have learned, the reason why there is no money for us to even afford printing paper in our schools, mm-hmm. by the way, I'm actually pretty surprised that I haven't been forced to use pink paper to send off my scholarship applications.
Go ahead.
Okay. Pink paper, and this is all because of some mishandling of the money and the, you know, some odd distribution methods. This is what I've learned. This is what I've learned from coming to these meetings. Now we, the students, are paying for our authorities' actions How are my friends and my brothers and people that I have come to call family, like people from drama club and from from my extracurricular activities after school, how are we going to get into colleges? I honestly think I'm not the brightest student, honestly. But because of what I've been involved in the past 2 years, that's literally the reason why I've been accepted to some of the colleges that I've been accepted to, and why I've been getting these scholarships that I've been getting. And, you know, how are we going to be able to do that? How are we going to prove that we're a competition to other schools in other counties, in other states? How are we going to prove that we're a competition? There's no competition if these, you know, these extracurricular activities, if these APs are taken away. How are we going to be any type of competition? How are we going to go off to any sort of college? What I have seen go on only in the year and a half that I have been here, I have learned that this district is stuck in Neverland. How will these students be prepared for the real world outside of these city walls? How is any of this helping us? You're cutting from public schools that barely have anything already. Meanwhile, there are private schools that are far better off than us that have been quote unquote cut from as well. Why are we being kept in the dark about these school cuts? Aren't we paying them? Aren't we paying for them? It's pretty backwards, but guess what? Change can be good, and it doesn't seem like you have a problem with changing certain things. All in all, what I'm saying boils down to two things. These cuts will only rip apart the East Ramapo School District and tear it to the ground. And two, what is done in darkness shall come to light.
Amen.
Amen.
But if I didn't have sports, I would not be the person I am now. I just moved to this district in August. I haven't been here for a full year yet. But if I didn't have soccer, I wouldn't have half the friends I have. If I didn't have softball, then I wouldn't be talking to anybody. I would have one friend. Sports teach you motivation, determination. They teach you what it's like to be like a good person. It teaches you how to become a leader. It teaches you everything. It's not just some after-school thing that you just go and do. You have to have dedication. It teaches you how to become an adult, pretty much. And if you cut the budget for sports 50%, then that's taking away so much from so many people. It's taking away friendships and basically just their futures, because like, you just can't take away the sports. You can't, because no one would be who they are if they did not play the sport they do. And all the drama clubs and AP classes, I'm not that smart. I'm not in AP classes or honor classes, but I know where they're coming from, because I wouldn't want something that I'm passionate about, like softball, to be taken away from me forcefully by people who aren't experiencing it themselves. If you guys actually care about the district that you're supporting, and are here to fight for, then you wouldn't cut budgets from things that need it, like people that need it. A lot of people need all these activities, and you're cutting the budget, and it's not going to help anyone.
My name is Kelly Peterson, and I assist coach the varsity softball. And what I want to say is that I graduated from Ramapo. And looking around right now, I notice I see a lot of lackadaisical posture, a lack of eye contact. And why I want to know that no matter what you perceive in me or the way I look right now, my presence demands respect. So please look me in the eyes when I speak to you. I am not an AP student. I never was, and I am not the smartest. A lot of the players on my team, they are not the smartest. They are not the most intelligent. But I bet you the girls who are lacking in math can tell you the proper angle to field a ball. I bet you the girls who aren't doing so good in English can tell you the proper terms when it comes to filling in that book or playing on the field. I cannot use AP classes to get into college because I was not an AP student. but I am an athlete. Athletics has helped me, and I am a female athlete. A lot of the females here, they don't have what it takes to get into the colleges like the male athletes. You have basketball, you have football, things that a lot of colleges look at. If you cut softball, where are they going to look? Where are these girls going to go? And I'll say it again. My presence demands respect, so please look at me when I speak to you. These are my softball girls, and I am proud of each and every one of them. My captain, one of my JV girls, and my shortstop. These girls are not the smartest, they are not the brightest, but I am really proud of them.